Well, I don't think there's any, I don't think we want to waste any more time. Let's bring him in. More hype to any radio character than I've ever seen in history. Let's bring in the D-Man. Is this Bachman Turner Overdrive?
Big fan.
Does he know about getting something up to a hawk, or it just starts at the beginning?
They get up every morning from the alarm clock's warning, take the 8:15 into the city. There's a whistle up above, and people pushing, people shoving, and the girls who try to look pretty. And if your dreams aren't...
All right, it looks like they're lowering an egg down from the ceiling. I don't know whether that's an egg or a sphere of some kind. All right, it's opening. What's at the top of the... There it is. There's the man, the D-Man, coming out. Coming down the steps. There's got to be about 80 steps here. I believe that step he's doing is called the mashed potato. Not exactly sure. All right, that I know is the pony. Bristol stomp. That's the jerk that he's doing. Back into the mashed potato. That's about a three-quarter split. How about 7/8 split now? Coming back up. Kind of. All right, he's just Poe going down the last ones. Here he is, everybody, the D-Man.
The D-Man is here.
How you doing, D-Man?
Doing great, Ronnie B. The B-Man meeting the D-Man. Nice to meet you, my friend.
Good to see you. Well, welcome to the show. Is there anything at all that you need?
I am good to go. This is my first time doing radio, Ronnie B.
Is that a handlebar mustache that you're rocking today?
That's a D-Manchu.
D-Manchu.
D-Manchu mustache is what I'm rocking today.
And, of course, this...
This will be catching on with all the kids listening to the show.
Well, there's not a lot of kids listening to the show. We don't do Top 40 radio. But,
when you can start growing your facial hair, kids, this is what you want. You want the D-Man Chew.
It's not really for children. We're an XL channel.
Fuck yeah!
Okay. D-Man, it's good to have you on board. I just want you to ease in and feel good here, but, It's great to have you.
Yeah, Ronnie B, I've done a lot of things over my life. I've been a sculptor.
Mm-hmm.
I've trained jungle cats.
Right.
I've been a fill-in dental hygienist.
A what?
Dental hygienist.
Okay. But what did you say before that?
Trained jungle cats.
No, but didn't you say something like fill-in dental hygienist?
Fill-in dental hygienist.
Oh, fill-in.
Yeah,
okay.
Substitute dental hygienist.
I
like a substitute teacher, except with dental cleaning.
I was hoping you said Philly dental hygienist. So I would have been excited.
I had a Meineke muffler franchise for a while.
Uh-huh. What kind?
Meineke.
Okay.
Perpetrator of insurance fraud on more than one occasion.
All right, so you've done a lot of stuff.
First time doing radio, excited about it.
This goes on the list.
Yeah.
Here's what I worry about, D-Man. How do we know that this isn't just going to be, you know, another throwaway dash on the resume?
On the road.
Yeah.
That's the great part. We don't know that. We don't know
that
it,
That is
man.
Great. That
I'm
is great.
I've been a soldier of fortune, my friend.
What do you mean by that?
Just going out there, an army collecting a one-man army collecting fortunes.
All right, so
sometimes it's with Meineke mufflers, sometimes it's in teeth cleaning.
So that's what soldiers of fortunes do. They go out as a one-man army collecting fortunes. Well, it's great to have you here, D-Man.
It's good to be here.
It's great to have you doing.
I'm very comfortable in this space.
Well, good. All right. Well, just feel free to jump in or. If there's anything that you want to talk about, bring it up. We were talking about Roger Ebert coming out immediately and kind of blaming Ryan Dunn's friends for being jackasses and letting them drive drunk. And the way Pepper and I looked about it, like, we could understand that people are going to have that opinion, but perhaps you should hold the opinion while the family is still mourning and friends.
Sounds good to me. I got one question for Robert, Roger Ebert.
What do you want to say to Robert Ebert? He's not here. I don't know what we're going to do with the questions, but yeah. What is it?
Did you say Siskel?
That's true.
You say Siskel. That's all. That one question.
That's a good. That's a really good
point. I want to get his ass up on the Twitter stand. Uh-huh. Ask him one question.
What's that question?
You say Siskel?
I like the fact that
I think I know the answer.
That D-Man doesn't even say did before you save Siskel.
No.
But, you know, it's a different thing. Siskel wasn't killed drunk driving. Siskel was killed by cancer. I think it was like a brain thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. But what did Ebert do? What did Ebert?
I don't know.
Did Ebert have to deal with tweets? After that, I don't think so.
You're asking
think
me
twice, Ebert. Think
you're
twice.
You're asking me a lot of questions I don't know the answer to here.
Say it to the guy's face, Ebert. Say it to his face.
Well, the person passed away that he said it about. Anyway, the D-Man is here, and as you can see right away, he has no problems just giving opinions. He'll put them out there. No. I mean, this is a guy who's been a Meineke muffler guy. I mean, he's done a lot of things in his life.
He's a fill-in dental hygienist.
In Philly?
Fill-in.
Let's go over here to Anthony in Boston. You're on Fez.
Hey, Ronnie. Sounds good to have a second mic. Hey, D-Man, do you ever do time in San Quentin? You sound like a guy I know.
Not San Quentin, but I'll tell you what. There's been some times where maybe partying a little too much, D-Man did some D-time. Downtime.
Does that mean that you're in jail or just had a hangover?
Basically a hangover.
Okay.
Oh.
Let's go over here to Jason. Jason, you're on Run of Fez.
I just want to let the D-Man know that he's got the best voice in radio I've ever heard.
Is that your actual voice there, D-Man?
This is it, man. This is the voice.
This isn't a radio. This isn't a radio, like a broadcasting train voice.
No, I hate those guys that do that. Come on, be yourself. That's what I always say. Be yourself. Be who you are. Be who you were born to be.
I don't know whether you said that or Lady Gaga. Let's go over here to let's go over to Lonnie. Lonnie, you're on the Run of Fest show.
Yeah, I was wanting to ask the D-Man, does D stand for the Dick Man, and what's his sexual preference?
D could stand for the Dick Man, of course, if it's your girlfriend talking to me, big boy. I'm sure that's her name for the D-Man.
What's that?
The Dick Man. Dick Man.
Ladies like you, huh?
Oh, ladies love me.
D-Man, do it again.
I had no idea.
D-Man, do it again.
You got your own drops there, huh?
They can't do it enough.
D-Man in the house!
This is
D-Man in the house!
That'll be what we do when he gets off a big line, Chris.
Okay. D-Man in the house!
John, you're on Run of Fez. John, go ahead.
Oh, I'm sorry. Ron, you sound like $1 million.
Thank you.
D-Man, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
I just have a quick question for you, D-Man. Does the D stand for Daddy's Dead? I didn't quite understand what the D meant.
D-Man does not know whether his dad is dead or alive. Never met the man.
D-Man in the house!
Let's go over here to Dan in Toronto. Dan, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Ronnie B. Something you might not know about the D-Man? He would have struck out Joe Carter in 93.
Oh, fuck you, Dan, and fuck 1993. 93 does not exist. We went from 92 to 94. Straight into the fucking strike year. Oh, God. I'm not going to get over it. Nate, you're on the Run of Fez show.
D-Man!
D-Man right here. D-Man in the house.
D-Man in the house!
What's cum taste like?
His question is, what does cum taste like?
Oh, man, I have no idea. Unless, of course, you slipped me some sort of roofie and you were in your way with the D-Man, my friend. If that's your fantasy, enjoy. The D-Man could stand for dream then, big boy.
I think that we should have like a very quiet D-Man in the house for when it doesn't quite get over. That's somewhat of a comeback, I think. Slipped me a roofie and fucked me in the mouth.
Yeah, and then I wake up with cum taste in my mouth.
All right, D-Man is not actually going to be working the roast yet. There's no doubt about that. But he is here, and he's glad to be here. Nate, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, buddies. Hey, D-Man, maybe instead of bringing breakfast in for Hicks like Fez did, you could bring in a hooker and you guys could run a train on her.
Did you bring anything in today with you, D-Man?
Well, I'll tell you what.
Anything for our own Pepper Hicks?
Nothing for Pepper Hicks, but to start off on the right foot with you, Ronnie B. Right there, nice box of cigars.
Whoa!
Present that to you, my friend.
Whoa!
First day. Holy shit.
And a box of Romeo and Julietta's.
I got the chef,
I can't start and tell you how much I like the D-Man.
Nothing but the best!
This is really nice.
The best!
Generous D-Man.
You know, I've never said this before to a co-host, but if you ever want to maybe stop at a cigar bar on the way home, we can enjoy a couple of these.
I'm in.
That was very, very kind of you.
I got no plans tonight.
That is surprising. I would have thought that you were keeping yourself pretty busy.
Fucking out in the town and shit.
D-Man, by the way, is dressed in a very loose-fitting V-neck T-shirt.
Yeah.
I guess he's in character.
And my favorite color, white.
What?
Okay. 866, run.
Favorite color, favorite race.
866, run, zero Fez. Here's Sean. Sean, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, I got a D-Man prediction for you, Ronnie.
Yeah.
I predict the D-Man's probably going to lose his voice by Friday.
Here's Ryan in Cleveland.
D-Man, got a question for you.
Shoot.
What's pussy taste like?
Oh, so sweet. Honeydew melon, my friend. Honeydew melon.
Right on, baby.
So he is confused. 866, run, zero Fez. 866, run, zero Fez. I'm going to tell you the truth, D-Man. If you get down there between it and it tastes like honeydew melon, spit it out. Because you might be with a diabetic. I don't know what's going on at that point.
Bad diet.
Really not expecting a honeydew melon taste. Rick, you're on the Run of Fez show.
I just want to say I love the D-Man, and D-Man, I'll go behind you on a hooker train any day. Keep up the good work.
Wow. Wants to swim through the D-Man's jizz. You know, early feedback here. Big, big love for the D-Man.
Oh, D-Man,
now,
juice.
D-Man, I hope you and I get along great doing the show. But I'm, you know, it's very, very strange for me not having Fez Watley here. It's always been, you know, Ron and Fez together, hanging out, doing stuff. But I have to admit, you're talking way more than Watley ever did. You're involved.
If you're missing Watley,
mm-hmm.
Find a little corner. I'm sure he's crying in it.
Come on, don't be like that.
Damn.
Seriously.
I'm sure he saw, you know, look for a trail of Kleenex. You'll find Watley.
I understand where you're coming from, D-Man, but here's the thing. That is my buddy, and I don't want you taking shots at him. I know that he's going through a rough time.
It's your old buddy. Now you're with the D-Man.
Right, but I can have more than one buddy, you know, and I would like you two guys to get along. I know he had a big, big weekend that his relatives were in to see him.
Yeah.
And Father's Day wasn't going to be the easiest thing in the world on him. So, you know, whoever cried, we don't care who's crying about what. Hey, Ryan, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Yeah, D-Man. Just wanted to know what the D was standing for, if it stood for dementia. It sounds like an early case.
This really does seem like a strange thing that no one actually knows what the D stands for.
No, could stand for deadly one day.
I will tell you this. I believe that D-Man Chew is already trending on Twitter. That shocks me.
Beautiful.
Hicks, are you going to D-Man show it up, or what's your story? That would mean that you'd have to take an extra couple minutes in the bathroom in the morning.
I'm not good at maintaining. D-Man show looks good, though.
Dan, you're on Run of Fez.
Yo, D-Man, what's your diet consist of?
People are talking to him like he just landed here from another planet. He's just a guy, a regular guy, a little more manly than most.
Exactly. I eat food. I eat really. I like to eat brown foods. Gravy, steaks, whatever.
You put gravy on your steak?
On my roast beef, all of it.
And also on your roast beef. 866-RON-0-FEZ. Let's go over here to Frank. Frank, you're on Run Fez.
Yeah, D-Man, what did you do on Father's Day?
D-Man, that never dad, didn't do much.
Oh, well, I thought you just never met your dad.
Never met him, don't know who he was, didn't grow up with one.
So orphan child, or as far as you know, Papa was a Rolling Stone.
Exactly, yeah.
You ever think about going to look for him, D-Man?
Don't want... I'm afraid of what could happen.
All right. 866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. D-Man starting with us here today. And I really don't think that he should be the center of all these questions.
I already made it through the job interview. I'm here.
866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. Here's Brent in Florida.
Hey, sure, D-Man's not Ron Diaz. I feel like I'm back at Ron and Ron's show.
No, it's definitely not Ron Diaz. 866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. Here's John. John, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, I'd like to ask D-Man what his favorite sexual position with the ladies is.
Now, would you ask that of a man? It's a very strange question, John.
Make sure I don't hang out in any bars with you. If this is what you're asking sober, next thing you know, you're going to be fondling me.
After roofing you and fucking you in the mouth and then coming in it. Brad, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, D-Man, what's up, buddy?
What can we do for you?
Hey, did you just...
You want to know about my sexual positions? You another guy who wants to talk about cum? What's going on?
Let's give him the chance to talk.
Did you say that white people's your favorite race? Or your disfavorite race? I think you just said white people is not your favorite race.
Yeah, favorite.
Daddy's a racist.
What do you got against white people, big man?
I think you dropped that line, buddy.
You got to get the wax out of your ears.
Good one, D-Man.
D-Man in the house!
Kind of. Get the wax out of your ears might be the new catchphrase.
Get the bumper stickers growing.
Is that how we get bumper stickers? We grow them?
I guess. I tried to turn that into rolling.
Me and my brother, we're bumper sticker farmers. Doing very, very well for ourselves. We're having a bumper crop of bumper stickers. Boy, you live so far in the fucking city, you don't even know where things come from.
Oh, hell no.
Hey, Higgs, by the way, hot as piss in this fucking room. It's like a fucking sauna steam bath.
All right. How you feeling, D-Man? You sweaty?
He's got a lobster in each hand. We're going to be eating in 5 minutes. He's just holding on to live lobsters. And melting butter. Two sticks of butter in front of him.
Damn.
Let's go over here to Sean. Sean, you're on the Run and Fez show.
Hey, Ron, I was going to ask the D-Man if he had a chance to plow Earl's grandmother before she passed.
Who's Earl?
Earl used to be a producer of ours.
If he had a hot granny, the D-Man probably got her.
Well, I thought you were racist.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, D-Man.
D-Man in the house!
He never knows.
D-Man in the house!
866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. Here's an old buddy of ours, Keith the Cop. Keith, how are you, buddy?
Hey, Ronnie D-Man, how are you guys?
We're great.
Just curious, with current events, now that he's in the city, how does D-Man feel about New York State and the gay marriage vote coming up?
Yeah, it's very, very close, D-Man. We may be getting gay marriage.
All right, yeah. Maybe I'll be moving on before you know it. Maybe the D-Man will be headed out the door.
That would actually drive you out of the city?
That could be, yeah. I don't need to see that on the streets.
So you won't be going to the parade this weekend on Sunday, then?
Yeah, there's a parade for the D-Man coming to town?
I consider the parade for the D-Man.
Absolutely.
It's a D-Man pride parade. All right, Keith, good to talk to you, buddy.
Thank you, pal.
Peace. Was that your stomach growling, D-Man?
D-Man got a little, yeah. Hungry, D-Man. I need some food before this is over.
What are you hungry for, D-Man?
This is early for me. When do we start? 11 a.m. in the East here?
Well, yes, we just call it 11 a.m. here.
Yeah.
We never think of calling it in the East. But yes, I guess you're right. This is the East.
Well, I guess Arizona has a different time zone, so.
I'm not even sure if he's from Arizona. I'm gonna be honest. I think Fez made a mistake. So anti-gay marriage.
Yep.
Wow. Surprises me. Now, I got no problem with this passing, D-Man. I don't see why we would want to keep people from doing what they want.
Oh, yeah. Then next thing you know, it's going to be people are going to want to marry a hippopotamus or something.
So you're saying slippery slope.
Absolutely.
I never
That's
even...
It's a slope that slides, my friend. It gets very slippery.
You know, you are... Well, the slope doesn't slide. We slide down the slope. But you are turning me around. Very, very quickly, like a chair on The Voice. I never thought of that because I was okay with gay marriage. But I'm not okay with a man marrying a hippopotamus.
That makes no sense.
And that's the slope that we're on.
That's where we're sliding down, right there.
You don't think it's like kind of a gravelly slope that maybe we could grab onto stuff before we get to the hippopotamus?
No, it's shined and polished. It is just slipping away.
I never thought of it that way either. I thought kind of muddy or slick. But you're saying it's like a marble slope.
Wow.
Like Teflon.
Like a Teflon slope, which would probably be the world's first. And I didn't know Keith the Cop knew that the Gay Pride Parade was this Saturday.
No.
Or is it Saturday or Sunday, Hicks?
I think it's Saturday. Oh, no, I just tried to keep
it
informed.
The float, big man.
Wow, that came quickly.
Jesus, D-Man.
By the way, I noticed that D-Man calls everybody big man.
Yeah, that's weird.
It's starting to be that. So if we're growing bumper stickers, that might be one of them.
I'll grow one of them.
Yeah.
Wax.
Here's Melly in D.C.
Hi there, boys. How are you?
Good.
I really need to know D-Man's situation. Are you single? What's going on? What's happening with that?
D-Man single?
D-Man's still out there in the field.
Never married, D-Man?
Never married. Never been caught.
Can we have a win a date with D-Man contest?
All right, by the way, Millie, you were down as Melly from D.C.
Yeah, he called me Nelly, he called me Bob, I don't know what's wrong with the kid.
Hex, who's on the fucking phones today?
That's intern with no name.
You know, he was doing so good with the songs, but he's a rat fuck on that on those phones.
He's not doing too well on the phones, he's still trying to get his legs underneath them.
Let's not say he's not doing too well. He's a rat fuck.
He's a rat fuck.
It's good to talk to you. So you're maybe a little interested in the D-Man.
Oh, yeah. If we're doing Win a Date with D-Man, I am down.
There may be that coming up. It may happen.
Make it happen, Ron. Please, make it happen.
The only problem is it's such a slippery slope. It's such a marble Teflon slope.
I'm okay with slippery, and I'm growing a D-Man chew. Right now, I'm starting my D-Man chew.
On her vagina. Pretty. On her vagina.
Yes. The important lips.
Oh, jeez. All right, thanks, Millie. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Millie doing a very early morning lip joke. Wasn't expecting that. Let's go over here to Amara, NPA.
Hey, D-Man, why is it you sound like an old Jewish grandma?
Maybe I'll tell you what, when a date with D-Man, I'll turn you around. I'll convert you.
That was a really good comeback, D-Man.
D-Man in the house!
I'll tell you what, I'll convert you and turn you around. 866-RON-0-FEZ, 866-RON-0-FEZ. Tim.
Hey, guys. D-Man, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Yeah, I just had a question for Ron. Ron, this is just great to have two people carrying the show instead of one. How do you like the reprieve from having to do all the work?
It's very, very interesting. It's a whole new dynamic having the D-Man in here. He's got me thinking now. You know, he's coming up with stuff that's got me. I'm like, hey, how do I feel about brown food? Do I like gravy on roast beef? He's coming in from a whole new angles. This slippery slope into, you know, if you marry, let gays get married, maybe a man would marry a hippopotamus. It's all got me thinking.
It's captivating.
866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. Adam, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Yeah, I got a bumper sticker for the D-Man.
What do you got?
The D-Man says, fuck it and chuck it.
Mike, in Albany, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, D-Man, I was wondering, does the D stand for Danza?
That would be great if it did. Fran, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hi, I'd like to get the D-Man's opinion on blueberry juice.
Yeah, D-Man, can it stand alone?
Yeah, it could stand alone. Blueberries are delicious. What kind of idiot would think that they couldn't stand alone?
Easy, D-Man. That's my really good friend, Fez, who doesn't believe that they're a standalone fruit. Let's try to play a little bit of Fez for D-Man and see if he can pick up on it.
Now, the blueberry is one that can't work on its own. It has to have something with it, like the kiwi. It's not a... standalone fruit.
What the fuck was that? That was a disaster. If D-Man stood for disaster, there's another D-Man running around, and his name's Fez Watley.
By the way, what is the accent that you have, D-Man? I know that your voice is deeper.
Vegas.
No, I've been to Vegas.
So, I don't know what that Fez Watley thing was. That was an embarrassment.
Well, that's just our Fez, D-Man.
And what the hell did he mean by blueberry standing alone?
Well, no one understood that. You're right about that part.
There's you go into a market, there's blueberries there.
True.
They're just standing there. They're in their own little containers, all right. Standing alone by themselves.
So you don't even think this was debatable?
No, it wasn't debatable. What was debatable is why didn't the D-Man get here sooner?
Lame Lips, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Yeah, this is a little awkward, but I'm a grown man. I'm married. I'm straight. But listening to the masculinity coming out of this guy, I'm really feeling horny for him. I want to be with him.
Grab a roofie. Maybe you'll mouth fuck him. Mike, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Apparently there's a parade you'll like next weekend.
Guys, I was wondering, why does D-Man sound just like Ian Halperin?
I think because they're both doing fake voices.
D-Man is trying to instill some masculinity across the airwaves to you, my friend.
Is that a shot at me?
No, not whatsoever.
Oh, good. Eric, Virginia, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, D-Man. So, the gay marriage thing is really, who knows where that could go. Do you think that could lead to someone making love to a cupcake?
See, our old partner, we teased him and said that he fucked a cupcake when he was little, but it wasn't true.
What the fuck was going on with that guy?
Well, you know.
I hope he's locked up at this point.
Well, he should be, but we let him out.
I don't want to think of him out on the streets.
It is a frightening idea. All right, Ron and Fez show, D-Man, filling in for the Fez today. People, of course, obviously very interested in him. But we would like to move on to other topics, give a chance for D-Man to give opinions. I don't know whether every question needs to be aimed straight at him. Let's go over here to Mike. Mike in Queens, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, D-Man, I'm at the supermarket, and someone asked me if I have any kids. I need a good comeback real quick.
Tell him not yet, but you're practicing.
D-Man in the house!
866 Ron Zero Fez. 866 Ron Zero Fez. Tyler, you're on Ron and Fez.
What's up going on, buddies?
Yeah.
I want to be the first D-Man Posse card holder number one, if that's okay with D-Man.
Yeah, I don't know whether we're doing D-Man card holders, but we'll let you know if we bring that up. It seems like it's very 2002 to have cards. Pat in Florida, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey there, Ron. Hey, D-Man, between you and Ron, who would win in a fight?
Oh, hey, no trouble out of me, D-Man.
Whoa. You're not going to see that fight.
D-Man, please. That's something we don't even have to consider.
You know what? You know when you're going to see a fight? Someone tries to go after my buddy Ronnie B.
Well, thanks. So you'll be watching out for me?
Always.
Even when you're drinking, D-Man? Even when you're drinking?
Especially.
Good.
Piss drunk, D-Man.
I'm telling you, D-Man comes rolling in here with beautiful Romeo and Julieta fucking cigars for me. Shocker. Just a shocker.
Wonderful gift.
It is. It's a gift that keeps on giving.